Hello, and welcome to St. Mary's Now, a partnership between the Enterprise newspaper and the Forest Center TV video production program. I'm Jessica Humans.
And I'm Jordan Amsbacher, and here's the latest news from the Enterprise. St. Mary's County has roughly $10 million in expenses for the 2020 working budget that revenues can support. The St. Mary's County Commissioners are eyeing a tax increase to pay for the shortfall. County Commissioner Todd Morgan said on Tuesday, the commissioners have campaigned on supporting public safety, supporting education, and being fiscally responsible. However, there are times when the moon and the stars don't align, and there are gonna have to be revenue advances or a tax increase, Morgan said. There's only one way of getting that revenue, and that's gonna be property taxes and income taxes. Residential property owners pay 3/4 of the county's real estate revenue.
The St. Mary's commissioners on Tuesday agreed to fund local public schools $4.4 million next fiscal year to pay for raises for school staff and other costs. However, they choose not to fund the $1.3 million requested for new safety and security positions at schools. Some of the 20 school safety positions the superintendent wanted to add are required through the Maryland Safe to Learn Act of 2018, a law that Dr. Scott Smith said was well-intentioned and seemingly had money attached to it, but that money is slow to finding its way to systems. The act requires 2 coordinator positions for mental health and safety and security, as well as security assistants. The plan was to add 10 positions in 2020 and 10 more in 2021.
A junior from Leonardtown High School recently won a national award in the creative writing competition. Anna Lee Hampton wrote a personal essay entitled First Day of Spring, which describes how she felt the day of the shooting at Great Mills High School last year. Her piece won a silver medal for the National Scholastic Art and Writing Awards. Hampton said, "That was definitely unexpected. I really didn't expect to get anything nationally." Hampton explained that her essay talks about her personal feelings and the general climate of Leonardtown High School on March 20, 2018.
Maryland's minimum wage looks even more likely to raise to $15 an hour after both legislative chambers passed a pair of bills and a committee resolved the differences between them. Versions of the bill passed in the House of Delegates with a 93-41 vote and in the Senate by a margin of 32-13, effectively making the final version veto-proof. The final bill will ultimately increase minimum wage from $10.10 an hour to $15 an hour by 2025 for companies with more than 15 employees. Companies with fewer than 15 employees will have until July 1st, 2026 to pay the new minimum wage.
For the Chapscon Braves, lacrosse season is getting off to a good start, with only a few light showers in the forecast for Monday. The Braves hit the field to practice throwing, passing, and dodging. Chapscon head coach Richard Kukrow said, "We're pretty young this year, so we're working on the fundamentals, like the pace of play and the working on some things to make it a varsity program. We're very inexperienced. The Braves only have 6 seniors on the team this season, with 4 being captains, and the rest fairly new to the sport. Senior midfielder Jacob Haynes, a co-captain, is excited to start off his final season of lacrosse with the Braves. Haynes says, "I feel pretty good because we're more of a team. We work harder together rather than in the past years I've seen. And a lot of kids have some good skills that I see, so it should be a good season."
This news brief has been provided by the Enterprise. For more details, visit somdnews.com. That's all we have for you on this edition of St. Mary's Now. I'm Jessica Unimans.
And I'm Jordan Amsbacher, signing off.